We started with discussing our clinical cases. So the aim of the workshop was to interact with other participants in order to understand the current clinical practice and try to define some key points in the management of patients with CLL. So we started defining reason for starting treatment. There are some specific indications, so not all patients with CLL require treatment at the time of diagnosis. Actually, it's only a minority, but they are followed usually over time. At some point during disease course, they could develop symptomatic disease and therefore require treatment. So we were first discussing the biological assessment, biological profile needs to be clarified before starting treatment, because this is currently guiding our treatment choice. So in patients carrying some specific abnormalities, including first 17p deletion and TP53 mutation, we should avoid the chemoimmunotherapy combinations that are still available in first line. But it is becoming more clear in the last years that also the immunoglobulin G mutation status is a relevant characteristic of the disease, and also patients carrying immunoglobulin gene that are unmutated should benefit the most from novel targeted agents combination and avoid chemoimmunotherapy. So this was discussed during the workshops, but we also focused on the treatment at relapse, and also in this case conditions requiring treatment should be weighted. We should not immediately start treatment at the reoccurrence of lymphocytosis, because this is not benefiting our patients. But as soon as the disease is becoming again active, different factors should be taken into account in guiding our treatment decision, including again the biological profile, and some markers should be repeated at the time of relapse in order to understand if something changed compared to first disease progression, but also previous treatment history and duration of response. And again, both in first line and at the time of relapse, of course, comorbidities present in the patient population, and it should be considered that patients with CLL are in general elderly patients with a median age diagnosis of about 72 years of age. So also comorbidities should be taken into account to define the best treatment choice.